for information. Thank you all for joining us today. This is a holy festival, and holy, it's so important to have cows for the holy festival. There is a lot of significance, and if you read about holy festival, the main way the holy was celebrated for thousands of years in India is with the cows. So without cows, there is no holy. So that is the significance of cows in the holy festival. So we brought the calf from our Santan Valley. He is 3 years old. Please go there and pet him. Sorry, 2 days old. Did I say 3 years? 3 days old. And his name is Shyamu. And he is still not eating grass yet. So we are only feeding him milk right now. So if you would like to go feed milk to the baby calf, please go to the tree at that end. Also, I want to say a few things about cow protection, why it is important. Cow protection is important not just for the cows, it is important for people also. Like somebody was mentioning some time ago, the topsoil of the earth is replenished by the cow's dung. And that is so important to maintain vegetation. So with that vegetation, we get food, and with food, we live, we survive. So cows are helping us not just by being there, but they're also helping with getting the soil ready for making plants grow. As you all know, if you use fertilizers, over a period of time, the earth soil gets worse and it cannot produce anymore without fertilizers. But with the cow dung, the earth is not damaged, and vegetables we can grow for a while. And also for protecting the environment is very important. And the way now you might have heard comments about cows produce methane. And I mean, we have lived in India for so long and cows never produce methane. Do you know why they produce methane here? It's because they're feeding them not grass but something else. So we have to correct that problem, and I'm glad so many of you came today to raise our awareness and raise our voice saying we need to protect cows by let them live naturally and then not kill them. So we don't want the slaughterhouses to kill the cows. And a lot of times people come and ask us, why cows, why not other animals? That's a very valid question. The reason we started with the cows is cows really get a very bad deal. I mean, we take milk from the cows, so the cows are feeding us indirectly through all the cheese products, and even if we eat pizza, we are actually depending on the cow's milk. So if you take that milk for so many years, and once the cow stops giving milk, killing that cow is wrong. Like when I was growing up, my mother said, if somebody gives something nice to you, you say thank you. But this is the opposite way. So we should not do that. So that's the reason protecting cows are very important. And at the same time, we have to protect animals. Like Ram Prasad was saying earlier, we as humans are given this higher position because we can show compassion. We can show compassion, we have the power to say, power to do something. We have intelligence slightly more than the animals, and we can protect the animals. That's why we are given this position. And to keep that position, we have to protect cows. And also, a couple of weeks ago, we have another visitor that came to our center, and she talked about the whale called Keiko. Any of you heard about the whale Keiko from Mexico City? Anybody heard? This whale was captured in Iceland, and the whale was brought to Mexico City to perform in a pool, like a SeaWorld, Mexico SeaWorld. And the whale, of course, it is a killer whale, and they brought him as a baby, and she grew too much, and then she was not fitting in the pool anymore. So in that while, how many of you have heard about the movie called Free Willy? Anybody heard about the movie called Free Willy? That came back in the late 90s. And with that movie, the whale became very popular. So everybody in the entire US especially, and whoever saw the movie worldwide, they fell in love with that whale, and they all fell in that movie. If you remember, the little boy takes initiative to free that whale, send it back to the ocean. So he captures the whale and he takes him out in kind of sneaks the whale out of the place and then he releases the cow, the whale into the ocean. So all that inspired a lot of kids, and with that, in the meanwhile, they already realized that the pool is too small and he was developing some skin irritation. So the small kids have started a big program. This was back in the late 90s, early 2000s. They started a big program to raise money to save the whale. And it was so powerful, they raised hundreds of thousands of dollars across all the schools in the country. And they influenced even the big companies. They influenced Warner Brothers, who produced Freewheelie, and they influenced Disney. So all of them actually paid. You know how much money they spent to get the whale back into the ocean? Close to $10 million. Warner Brothers gave $8 million, and then Disney gave a few million. And why I'm saying this is, all of this happened because of the kids. The kids wanted that whale to be free, and they raised money, they raised awareness across the country, US, Mexico, everywhere. And UPS donated a plane to take the cow, and in Oregon they built a makeshift pool for the whale, a huge pool for the whale to be trained to go into the wild. So they built this makeshift pool and trained that whale for a few years, and then sent that whale again, UPS sent them to Iceland, and release that whale back into the free ocean. So that's what kids could do, young kids from middle schools, elementary schools, and high schools. They have accomplished so much. If only these little kids could do that much, some of the adults here, we can do quite a bit. And it all takes some inspiration, it all takes some interest, some commitment. So it is a very inspirational story that I heard. If any of you are interested, you can search for this video on YouTube, how Keiko was taken back to Iceland. And in later on, I saw some more documentaries, and they said whales have bigger brains than us. Of course, they're bigger animals. And the researchers found out that they have some part of the brain that is responsible for the affection. They have much bigger than the humans. And these whales, when they are in the ocean, they grow in the ocean together. The kids do not leave the parents. So they all grow together as one family, one group of families. They don't leave the parents even when they are grown up. So that is far beyond what humans are able to do. So they are representing much higher level of affection and all those feelings. And likewise, the animals do have some intelligence. And if some of you have seen, in India recently there was an incident where a monkey actually gave a CPR to another monkey. You won't believe it. I mean, I was really shocked. After seeing that video, I thought, oh man, my life is worthless because I could never save any person. But if you saw that video, this one monkey got electrocuted by 25,000 volts line electricity, and then the monkey almost died. And then this other monkey came over, and he literally worked on that monkey for 15 minutes. He didn't give up. He did all sorts of different moves. He bit him and he put him in water and did all of those things. And finally, the other monkey was alive. So that was such an amazing thing. So the animals do have a lot of affection. They have some capabilities that even we don't have. And only the reason we are not able to see that is we are not acknowledging. So that's the eye-opener for me, these two incidents, and I want to bring them to your attention. So Holi is very important for cows. So we want to get your help, get your support for supporting these animals. And Rajesh Prabhu was just reminding me that Holi colors we will do on the other side in that sand. So if you have heard about Pankaj, what Pankaj Prabhu said, we do have programs for supporting this calf and other cows. So if you could please support us, there are different donation programs, $21, even $21 per month will help us support the cow. So please support the cow. And now I think it's time for doing the Holi colors. We got permit for this park, but they don't want any colors on this floor. So please make sure you are playing colors only on that side of the park and the volleyball court. Volleyball courts. The colors are available on the table. If you haven't got your colors, you can get them from there. We also have a raffle If you haven't bought those tickets, the raffle tickets are $1 each. Please make sure you buy those tickets. So we have some giveaways after this colors. We are going to give away some prizes for the raffle. Thank you so much. Now we can start Holi.